for our expert.
चल पता है नीरज नागर शेयर में ना अच्छे से बात नहीं करेंगे.
गुड मॉर्निंग
सर्टिफिकेट सर प्लीज सम वर्ड ए फ्यू वर्ड फॉर एक्सपर्ट.
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ द मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द SIRTS एंड द सेज ग्रुप आई वेलकम टुडेज स्पीकर डॉक्टर दीपक स्वामी सर फ्रॉम द IIM मंडी इन द आवर सेज टॉक. I am also welcome to all the participants in the stage talk. Definitely the stage talk will provide us the knowledge related to the hydraulics. I am also welcome to the all the participants again in this stage talk. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Vidosh. And thank you, Dr.
Over to Dr. Deepak Swami. Kindly start your session. I welcome sir again. Kindly start your session.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, one and all who are joining from their bed and from their office. I can see one student is in his home, probably Himanshu, right? Yeah. So basically, the topic of today's talk is about the mystery of the Reynolds transport theorem and the Navier-Stokes equation. As a mechanical engineer and as a civil engineer, you must be aware that there are a number of hydraulics problems which we encounter in a day-to-day life, and sometimes they are simply solved by the formula like Bernoulli equation or continuity equations. But all these fundamentally came from essentially from the Navier-Stokes equation. These are the special case solution of the Navier-Stokes equation. Now, before jumping to the topic of Navier-Stokes equation or the Reynolds transport theorem, there are certain properties of the fluid which you must be aware of, because those who are joining from their office or from their home, you must be aware that there are fluids around you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
There is some disturbance coming from. Hello?
Sir, you are audible. Please continue.
Please mute all the participants, sir, except the sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
I will
please mute all the participants except the sir.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So we are quite, you know, surrounded by the fluids, and while solving the problem related to the fluid, we must be aware about the concepts of Reynolds transport theorem and Navier-Stokes equation. Because as an expert here, I have many PhD and MS students who are doing their research with me. But when it comes to the interview, I have interviewed like hundreds of the students for the PhD position or for the master's position. And I encountered that most of the students are weak in the concept of Reynolds transport theorem and Navier-Stokes equation. Like out of 100, only 10 or 15 students would, you know, be able to answer the fundamental questions related to the Reynolds transport theorem or the Navier-Stokes equation. While teaching Navier-Stokes equation here to the mechanical engineering student, when I joined in 2015 IIT Mandi, the first batch who appeared for an first batch of the mechanical engineering students who appeared for interview in ISRO, they were essentially asked about very interesting question that if you are carrying a liquid in a satellite in the space, can you tell me that what kind of pressure it will generate to the conduit and what will be the velocity profile? And my student who learned and learned the concept of Navier-Stokes equation were able to solve it, and they got placed. So only one student got placed. So with that, I will start, because before understanding the Navier-Stokes equation, we must know the application of the Reynolds transport theorem. So what is Reynolds transport theorem? We all are aware about the concepts of. My screen is visible to you, all right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, so, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Before starting the fluid, we know that when a water is in the pipeline, it moves with a velocity v, right? If a pipeline, it contains the water, let's say this water, and we say that this is moving with a speed v. This V has come from the concept of Newton's law of motion, which essentially says that Newton's law of motion are applicable to a body. When we are talking about the water, it contains hundreds and thousands and billions of the molecules. To give you a rough idea about how many molecules in a pipeline, in a glass full of water, 250 ml glass of water contains 10^28 H2O particles. 10^28 H2O particles. So you can count that how many water in particles H2O molecule present in a glass of water, and each of these water particle will be moving with a velocity v. But when we talk about a water which is going through a pipeline having velocity v, when we calculate discharge, q is equal to av. A is the area of pipe, circular area, cross sectional area of the pipe, and v is the flowing water's velocity. We essentially consider all the bunch of these particle which are moving along as one body. So when we develop this kind of concept, combining all the bunch of particle into one singular body, this concept is known as Eulerian flow description. I will go in the detail of this Eulerian flow description, don't worry. So there are two types of fluid flow description. One is Lagrangian flow description, and another is Eulerian flow description. So when you talk about Lagrangian flow description, essentially, if in any space, let us consider two axes, x and y. All right. If y is representing x and y, both are representing the position of any moving particle. If this is a particle which is moving freely in the space. All right. So the position of this particle with respect to time will keep on changing. Let's say this is position one. Let's say this is position two. Let us assume that these are the fluid particles in a pipeline. Okay, so this position will keep on changing. In Lagrangian flow description, this position P is only a function of time t. All right, and in Eulerian flow description, this position P is function of x, y, z, and t. I'll give you an example that how the Lagrangian and Eulerian flow description can be, you know, very well understand for a student. For example, you are moving out of class, and if I tag a GPS on you, after time t, wherever your position is, okay, that can be described by the Lagrangian flow description. अगर आप क्लास से बाहर चले गए और आपका हमने बोला कि 5 मिनट बाद ये स्टूडेंट कहाँ मिलेगा, तो वो 5 मिनट बाद जिस जगह पे मिलेगा वो उसकी नई पोजिशन है, और आपकी जो पोजीशन है वो केवल टाइम का फंक्शन है, क्योंकि हमने यहाँ पर केवल टाइम में मेजर किया है कि आपकी पोजीशन 5 मिनट बाद क्या होने वाली है। ऐसे ही अगर हम एक पार्टिकल को देखें और उस पार्टिकल को ट्रैक करते रहें लेबल करके, और देखें कि हर 5 मिनट बाद उसकी पोजीशन क्या है, और ये एक सर्टेन टाइम ड्यूरेशन के बाद में, तो ये लैग्रेंजियन फ्लो डिस्क्रिप्शन होता है, विच इज द बेसिक ऑफ द न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ मोशन। क्योंकि अगर आप न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ मोशन की जितनी भी इक्वेशन देखेंगे, दोज आर ऑल फंक्शन ऑफ टाइम। नाउ इन केस ऑफ यूलेरियन फ्लो डिस्क्रिप्शन, ये इसमें जो है पार्टिकल की जो भी पोजीशन है वो एक्स वाई जेड, जो कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम होता है एक्स वाई जेड, वो और टाइम सबका फंक्शन होता है। इसी वजह से जो रेनॉल्ड ट्रांसपोर्ट थ्योरम है, दिस ब्रिज द गैप बिटवीन लैग्रेंजियन फ्लूइड फ्लो डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड यूलेरियन फ्लूइड फ्लो डिस्क्रिप्शन, बिकॉज द वाटर पार्टिकल्स कैन नॉट बी अज्यूम्ड अ बॉडी, वेयर एज वी कैन नॉट डेवलप एनी कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फ्लूइड फ्लो विदाउट अज्यूमिंग all the water particle as a body. All right, so Reynolds transport theorem has been developed to bridge the gap between these two, where we can assume a bunch of independent water molecules as a body. With that, I will move on. So before defining further about the Reynolds transport theorem, there are two properties of the fluids which we must be aware of. One is extensive property, and the second is intensive property. एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी इज लाइक इट्स अ फैट पर्सन, अगर हम बोले कि एक बच्चा है, पालक है, वो बहुत ज्यादा खाना खाता है और मोटा होता जाता है, तो वो जितना खाना खाता जाएगा उतना मोटा होता जाएगा। तो ऐसे ही एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी को अगर फ्लूइड के लिए हम बात करें तो ये जो डिपेंड होती है मास पे डिपेंड होती है, जितना मास आपका इंक्रीज होता जाएगा एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी भी इंक्रीज होती जाएगी। अच्छा, इसका एग्जाम्पल क्या हो सकता है, जैसे कि काइनेटिक एनर्जी हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर, एम जैसे जैसे बढ़ता जाएगा आपकी एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी भी बढ़ती जाएगी। ऑलराइट, एंड इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी आर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ मास, इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ मास, यानी कि ये ऐसा लड़का है जो कितना भी खाना खाएगा लेकिन बिल्कुल मोटा नहीं होगा। सो अगर इसको और सिंपल एग्जांपल में मैं बताऊं तो जैसे फ्लूइड का जो होता है विस्कोसिटी, चाहे आप इसको डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी ले लें या काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी ले लें, ये जो है इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी, इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ मास। ओके, अब जब हम इंटेंसिव और एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी की बात करते हैं और ये डिफाइन कर देते हैं कि इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी और एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी क्या है, तो इनके बीच का एक रिलेशन भी हम लोग डेवलप कर सकते हैं, विच कैन बी मास ऑफ एनी फ्लूइड कैन बी रिटर्न एज इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी मल्टीप्लाई बाय वॉल्यूम। ऑलराइट, इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी मल्टीप्लाई बाय वॉल्यूम, और अगर हमको पूरी बॉडी का मास निकालना है, लेट्स से दिस वाज मास इन फ्रैक्शन, इफ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द मास फॉर होल बॉडी, देन वी कैन क्लियरली राइट डाउन कैपिटल एम विल बी इज इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशन ओवर एंटायर वॉल्यूम, एंड रो इज द मास पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम एंड मल्टीप्लाई बाय डीवी। सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मास इन द रेनॉल्ड्स ट्रांसपोर्ट थ्योरम। ऑलराइट, and sometimes when we say mass it is also extensive property and this can be shown by zeta. So please remember that all the intensive properties are shown by zeta and the intensive properties are shown by eta, and zeta and eta are related by this relation. Okay, so when we talk about the extensive and intensive property, these are the basic fluid property which one must be aware of. All right, now there are three more definition. One is control volume, which is very important. Another is control surface, and the third definition is system. So before jumping on to the derivation of Reynolds theorem, we must be aware about these property which I talked about. The first thing was that water as a whole is a assemblage of the H2O particle.
आई थिंक सर डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए हैं।